One should fear that if they go out for a run, they will be targeted and killed because of the color of their skin. The Justice Department has a legal obligation to prosecute hate crimes. And as Americans, all of us have a moral obligation to combat the hatred and bigotry that motivates those crimes.
In that video, you see Merrick Garland finally doing a day's work. That's good. Nothing else for him to be investigating. Announcing that the three white Georgia men who murdered Ahmaud Arbery have been found guilty of a federal hate crime, determining that the crime was motivated explicitly by racism. This follows up previous charges and all that. But it does mean that there's a little bit of resiliency against some of the charges being overturned, that sort of thing. And makes it even more likely that they will be spending a very long time, potentially the rest of their life, in prison. We'll give you more details, but Ray, what do you make of this?
Yeah, I think it's a really good thing. I think that we should see more of this because it's extremely uncommon. Hate crimes are not prosecuted very often because there's a lack of judicial resources, or it's a strain on the judicial system, so they only go after things that they think are surefire, hate crime cases, and sort of a lot of these other things that were absolutely hate crimes are left by the wayside. So, but it's good to see it actually, working the way that it's supposed to in this case, because it was such a blatant, disgusting, horrendous act of hate.
Yeah, the actual act horrendous, the fraught extended path to getting justice in the case, also scary. We'll give you those numbers, but Rayyvana rightfully alluded to the fact that they don't often pursue these sorts of charges. In fact, the DOJ between 2005 and 2019 pursued just 17% of the hate crime incidents it was presented with. That doesn't mean that the DOJ or the people they'd be putting in charge don't think that the others might be instances of hate crimes, but obviously it's difficult. This is America after all. And so in any event, that is certainly good news. I will remind you, as I alluded to earlier, that prosecutors didn't charge the men until more than 10 weeks after they'd murdered Ahmaud Arbery. And this is one of many cases where if that video had not come out, totally different outcome. These guys would be off stalking other people throughout their neighborhood right now. And so we are constantly reminded that having video, body cam footage, stuff like that does not guarantee justice. Nothing even close to it. There are a lot of juries that can look at an obvious, very clear case of murder, and what do you know, they end up siding with the cops. But sometimes it does provide an opportunity. And so at the very least here, we had that.
Yeah, and it just does make you worry, or sit and think about all of the, countless victims of hate crimes and the families of the victims of hate crimes who have been seeking and fighting for justice for themselves or for their loved ones who weren't able to obtain it because maybe it wasn't as, didn't catch people's attention the same way that, the people fighting and demanding justice for Ahmaud Arbery, was able to gain traction and sort of become viral. There's tons of victims, and unfortunately for people who have been murdered, families of victims who are fighting for that same justice and will, might not ever see it because our judicial system isn't created to be just. It isn't created to have some form of justice, and particularly for people of color and other underrepresented groups who are the victims of hate crimes.
Exactly. Yeah. And as many people are noting, both in the chat and in our document, today is 2 years to the day that the murder actually happened. So, symbolically too important to get that conviction there. And I realized I didn't actually say what the sentence was. They now face up to life in prison for the federal crimes, as well as the life sentences they received in state court previously. So again, we'll have to see exactly how that sentencing process goes, but it does look like that's probably it for them. Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.